sí, faringitis. Faringitis or pharyngoamygdalitis is the infection of the amygdalas. Usually is of viral etiology, but also could be some bacterial etiology. The most common cause would be viral, but some frightened diseases also would be for Streptococcus pyogenes. So we are going to do a rapid test first in order to know if it is Streptococcus pyogenes. If it is positive, we will give antibiotic, and if not, we will continue to cultivate. We will see this in the as the video is advancing. Now, the things that can orientate to Streptococcus pyogenes amygdalitis or pharyngitis is some cough, high fever, cervical lymphadenopathy, strawberry tongue, petechias in the soft palate, and things that orientate more to viral pharyngitis are coriza, rhinitis, and rhinorrhea. This usually is more of viral etiology and it is of Streptococcus pyogenes. So next step is we are going to calculate the center criteria. This is, we are going to assignate some points to the presentation of the patient. This is fever, cough, cervical lymphadenopathy, anterior lymphadenopathy, age between 3 and 14 years, age between 14 and 45, or more than 45. All of these are 1 point, one, no point, minus 1 point. If we have from 4 to 5 points, treat immediately with a penicillin. If don't, if it is 2 to 3 points, then we do the testing that I was talking at the beginning. We are going to do the rapid testing for the streptolysin that are some enzymes produced by the Streptococcus pyogenes. So if this is positive, then we treat it with penicillin. If it is negative, we do culture. In the culture, if the culture is positive, we treat it. If it is negative, so we do not culture and we do not treat it. We do not treat, and there is no further assessment nor treatment. And if it is 0 to 1, we usually do not treat it and just give some supportive therapy. It could be Astamine, for example, for the fever, or things along that line. For penicillin, for Streptococcus pyogenes, the treatment is penicillin G for 10 days intramuscular, or penicillin B orally also for 10 days. Additional or other antibiotics that we can use if we don't have penicillin could be amoxicillin plus clavulanate, or some cephalosporin, or clindamycin. All this for 10 days. Complications. Supportive are, first could be sinusitis, otitis media, continuing with cervical lymphadenopathy. Could be life-threatening. The peritonsillar abscess. This presents with muffled hot potato speech. This is like if the patient is burning the mouth, and so it's talking like if the patient were taking a hot potato and is talking like that. And we will see enlargement of the affected tonsil, enlargement and tenderness, and deviation of the uvula and soft palate away from the affected tonsil. Next, if this peritonsillar abscess is not treated, can progress to mediastinitis of the of the posterior mediastinum. This spread to the posterior mediastinum is life-threatening because can lead to pleural or pericardial effusion. So it is very important to treat it. If we do not localize it, we can use a CT scan. And we should drainage it. Other complications are the thrombophlebitis of the jugular vein, internal jugular vein, also called Lemierre's sign. This thrombophlebitis is the septic infection of the jugular vein that produces embolus that can dislodge and go or to the brain or into the right heart and then to the pulmonary artery, and would present like an endocarditis of the tricuspid valve. So could go to the tricuspid valve or to the brain. This is the complication. This is Lemierre's sign. Other complications that we should be aware are not related to streptococcus pyogenes or to amygdalitis or other kind of amygdalitis or pharyngitis would be the Ludwig angina. Ludwig angina is some cellulitis, edema of the tissue, the submandibular and submaxillar, submandibular and sublingual area, usually after a molar abscess, and that is spreading, and so we have this necrosis. We should treat it with broad spectrum antibiotic, and if we see the abscess, we should drainage it. And usually it's of mixed flora. The other is Vincent angina. In Vincent angina, we have again like mixed flora. Also, Selenomonas, Treponema, and Fusobacterium. This and present with ulceration of the amygdala. Also, the thrombophlebitis is of this Fusobacterium and Necrophorum bacterium, bacterium gram negative bacteria, anaerobic bacteria. And this is more commonly seen in children, but anyway, this.